So let's start with states in articulate storyline. A state in articulate storyline is a certain state of an object. And the easiest way to explain this is a button in storyline. So let's add one. And to add a button, we go to the insert tab. I go to button, select one of them, for instance this one, and I draw it on my slide. Now if my button is selected, I can type text in it, for instance button, and I can also add an icon, here an arrow key. So if you have selected your button and you're clicking here on the state step, you'll see that Storyline has several built-in states for the button. You'll see a hover state, a down state, a visited state, and a disabled state. Now, for example, Storyline shows the hover state when a user hovers with his mouse over the button, and the down state becomes visible when a user presses a button. Storyline shows the visited state when a button is clicked, and the disabled state is used when a button is not clickable. For instance, a button that does not work if a user had not yet answered a question on a slide. You can change the different states by clicking on the Edit States button. Now you can select a state, for instance, the visited state, and you can change the icon or the color of the button. So when I want to change the color, I can choose here orange, and you see that my visited state becomes orange. So, and I could also change the icon if I select my disabled state and I change another icon. So now you see that the disabled state has another icon than the other states of my button. Now almost every object in Storyline can have states. And we've seen that a button already has a set of predefined states by default. But if we, for instance, make a shape, then you can see that Storyline only gives this a standard and normal shape. So let's make a shape. I'll go to my insert tab and I'll draw a shape. So now it's selected and you'll see on my state tab that only has a normal state. But you can give objects in Storyline also custom states. And this can you do by clicking on the Edit States button and clicking on New here, New State. And now you see here that you can choose from several predefined states for this object, or you can also create your own state. For instance, completed. And you can click on add, and now there is a custom state completed for this object. So, and if you create a new state, for instance, this completed state, what Storyline does, he copies the normal state to the new state. And now if you select this, you can adjust the state that we've just made. For example, by adding changing the color of the state or adding extra elements in the state. And this can be a different Storyline objects, even videos. So if I click on a caption, for instance, and I draw a caption here, then you see that my completed state has a blue rectangle and also a caption in it. So in this I can also do for instance a hover state. That is, I hover with my mouse over an object, that the hover state contains a video, contains an extra image or a text object. There's one last thing about states that I want to tell you. If you select an object, you can set the initial state for this object. Now it's on normal, you can select the completed state, but what you also can do is set it to hidden. Now the state is on your slide, but it is not visible for a user, and you can use triggers to set the other state. So let's move on to triggers to see what you can do with triggers and states to build cool interactions in Storyline. You can use triggers in Articulate Storyline to perform actions at a specific moment. To create a new trigger, go to your triggers panel and click on new. And now the triggers wizard will open. In Storyline, triggers are always made up of three components. The first component is what happens in the trigger. So in this example, there's an action that says jump to slide. So what happens is that the user jumps to another slide. Now which slide it is, can you see here? It's the next slide, but you can also pick one of the other slides in your project. The second thing is when does it happen? This happens in this example when the timeline starts. And where will it happen? This is the object, and for this example is it the untitled slide. That's the name of this slide. Now you can also say when does this happen if a user clicks on a button. We have our rectangle that has a hidden state. So now let's create a trigger on this button that shows the rectangle when we click on the button. So the first thing that I do is I select the button and now I'll go to new trigger. The first question that I ask myself creating a new trigger is, what want I do to happen? Here it is, I want to change the state of an object. So I choose the trigger change state of. Now, on which object? It's here the rectangle. To state completed or normal. So let's say normal. When has to be this executed? When a user clicks on button 2. So now let's click OK. And if you now preview this slide, you can see that if I click this button, the rectangle appears on my slide, and this button now shows the clicked state. What you also can do with triggers and states is to change the state of a menu item. So let's go to the first slide in this project. I have here 4 menu items, and let's select the first menu item and I click on states. You see that there are different objects in my state, and this menu item has only one state. So let's create a new menu item. I click on edit states, click on new, and give this the name completed. And click on add. Now let's add a check mark to this state. So I'll go to insert, shape, and here's check mark. So I can set the check mark here and can make it green, for instance. So now the completed state has a check mark on it. So what we now can do with triggers is to add a trigger that is executed when the timeline starts, that checks if a certain value is true, for instance, a variable. And when this value is true, the trigger will be executed and the state of this object will be set to completed. Now, if you want to know more about variables and how you can use them in Storyline, I've put a card to my video about variables here at the right. So you can click it and can watch my video about variables, or how you can use variables in Articulate Storyline. Now let's add our trigger.
Do you have any questions so about text entry triggers fields, panel. Text variables, or variables
I'll
in common?
Choose
then leave a comment below this video and I'll promise
object.
I'll answer
here
it.
Is this icon. I want to change it to completed and not when the user clicks, but when
if this video
my
was,
timeline starts, and it's not the timeline
if
of
this video
icon
was useful
one, but
to
the timeline
you, then
of
give
my
this
slide.
Video a like.
And now you can also choose a condition, for instance. So if you click on the blue plus sign here, you can
if this video was useful to you, then don't forget
with a variable, for instance, that you can say
if this video
you can create a variable that's called completed chapter 1.
And don't forget
you set it to
completed
chapter
1
to true on your last slide. And when you now come to your
if this video was
slide,
useful to you,
this trigger
give this
will
video
be,
a like.
Check
and don't
the
forget to hit the subscribe
when the
button
true,
and the bell notification icon so you won't miss
of
any of my upcoming videos.
Completed, and you'll see the check mark so you know that you completed your first chapter. Now we've seen in the
if
example
this video was useful to you,
a go
give
to
this
slide
video a
trigger
and don't
a change state of triggers. But there are many more triggers in Storyline.
If this video was
so
useful
let's see
to you,
which
then don't forget.
Are. So if I go to action, you can see my triggers.
If
I can
this
show
video
a layer,
was
hide
to you,
a layer,
then
jump
give this
to a slide,
like.
Or jump to a scene.
And don't forget to subscribe to
object,
my YouTube channel
media,
and hit the bell
it,
notification icon.
Exit
so
my
you
course,
won't
set my course to complete
miss
it.
Any of my
I can
new
adjust variables,
upcoming videos.
Pause my timeline or
thanks
resume
for watching and have a nice day.
Jump to a URL or a specific file. I can execute bits of variable of a JavaScript,
if this video
but I can
was
also
useful to you,
submit
a give this
question
video a
interaction
like. And don't
or
forget
submit
to hit
quiz
the subscribe
results.
Button and the bell notification icon so you
and we've
won't
just seen
so
that there are
be
many options
every
when
time
a user,
I release a new video.
When
thanks
a trigger
for watching,
is executed,
and have a great day.
But there are also many options when a trigger is executed.
If this
saw
video was
when
useful
a user
to you,
clicks
then
or
give
when
this
a timeline
video a
starts.
Like.
But
and
you
don't
can also
to hit
say
the subscribe button
when its
state and the bell
changes,
notification icon
when an animation completes,
don't want to miss
when an
any
object
of my upcoming videos
or the intersection ends.
Thanks for watching.
When an object
and have
leaves
great day.
The slide or enters it, when a slider moves or dial turns, if one of my variable changes, so you have a lot of possibilities to use triggers in your Storyline projects.
Do you want to know how to create engaging e-learning and architected storyline, then make sure you get my step-by-step guide on how to create engaging e-learning and articulated storyline in less time. I know it will help you, and it shows you my process that I'll use for every e-learning and articulated storyline. You can download my free guide from airportonlinelearning.com/free-guide. Do you have any questions about triggers and states, or questions about Articulate Storyline 360 in common? Then leave a comment below this video and I'll promise to answer it. If this video was useful to you, then hit the like button below. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I post weekly videos about Articulate Storyline every Thursday. Thanks for watching and have a great day!